Hello dear students, welcome to the demonstration of stepper motor interfacing with 8051 microcontroller. This is one of the assignments in processor architecture and interfacing. To begin with, look at this particular interfacing diagram to interface 8051 with the stepper motor. In this interfacing diagram, you can see here that this is the 8051 microcontroller and this is the stepper motor. Between 8051 microcontroller and stepper motor, there is a stepper motor controller, and that IC you can call it as a driver IC, that is stepper motor driver IC. In this case, the driver used is LN2003 driver. So its function is just to increase the driving capacity. Otherwise, the voltage level whichever are there at the input, so they are as it is transformed to its output. So it has got four inputs and four outputs. The four outputs of the driver, they are connected to the inputs of the stepper motor. The stepper motor is interfaced using port 2. Four lines of port 2 are used here for interfacing the stepper motor. It is possible to rotate this particular stepper motor in either forward direction. It has got two, we are going to demonstrate two operations, that is in the forward direction and in the reverse direction. So for that purpose, the port 0 pins are used here to indicate whether the operation of the stepper motor will be in the forward direction or with the reverse direction. So user can select that forward operation or reverse operation using two push buttons. So this is one push button. If this push button is pressed, then the operation of the rotation of the stepper motor will be in the forward direction. And if this push button is pressed, then the operation of the stepper motor will be in the reverse direction. What happens if these push buttons are pressed? If these are not pressed, then this line forward, okay, so which is connected here, or this reverse which is connected to the second line of the port 0. So both these lines, when these keys are unpressed, then they are connected to VCC. This is connected to VCC. So there is plus 5 volt on each of this line. That means the input is 1. As soon as you press either forward key or reverse key, then one of the line will be connected to ground. That means it will be the input or the voltage level at one of these will be 0. So depending on whether the forward line is 0 or reverse line is 0, the motor will rotate either in the forward direction or it will rotate in the reverse direction. If both of them are 1, the motor will neither rotate in forward direction nor it will rotate in the reverse direction. There is a specific set of sequences which should be given on these inputs A, B, C and D. So that particular sequence should be sent to the stepper motor so that the stepper motor rotates in either forward direction or in the reverse direction. So if that particular sequence is given in a specific direction, then it rotates in the forward direction, and if the same sequence is given in the reverse direction, then it will rotate in the reverse direction. So basically you can see here that the 8051's two ports are used for interfacing: stepper motor port 2 4 lines and port 0 2 lines for controlling the direction of the motor. Whereas you can see the rest of the pins, they are ports, they are unconnected, whereas a few of the important pins, they are connected appropriately. AA bar is connected to ground so that there is no external memory. Restart circuitry is connected to RST, and a crystal generator is connected between these crystal lines of 8051. So rest of the pins they are left open, and of course the plus 5 volt and power, they are connected, which are not shown in this particular diagram. The program for this particular stepper motor control is shown here. So you can go through this particular program. First we shall go for the demonstration, and after that we shall go into some part of this particular program. So before going to the demonstration, as I just explained, that certain sequence of zeros and one should be sent to the stepper motor. And what is that sequence? It is this sequence, that is 02, 06, 04, followed by 0C, then 08, 09, 01, 03, and again 02. So if this particular numbers are sent in this direction, then the stepper motor will rotate in the forward direction. Instead of sending this in the forward direction like this, if this particular sequence is sent on port 2 like 03, 01, 09, 08, 0C, 04, 06, and then 02, and again back to 03, so like that, then the stepper motor will rotate in the reverse direction. So let us go for the demonstration of this. We are going to see the demonstration using a simulation software that is Protes. So you are able to see the screen for the Protes software, and the schematic is already drawn here, okay, or the devices are already placed. You can select the devices from this side, or if required you can go and select some devices from this list. For example, here you can go and select the devices. For example, you can have 8 9 sorry 8 9 C 5. So these are the options which are available for selecting the 8 9 C 5 1 microcontroller and all that. Okay, so you can select some device and you can get that device into that particular list. So like that, you can select many devices. Like you can select LEDs, you can select transistors. So like that, you have different options. But already this particular drawing is drawn here. And after these components are placed, that is, for example, you can select a capacitor here. So I can place a capacitor here, and I can make, then you can select a button and you can make the connections between these capacitor and button and like this. Okay, so all these connections and all this, it is already selected, so I'm going to remove all these things from here. So basically this is 89C51 microcontroller. It's reset circuitry, the crystals, then this is the button for the forward and rotation. This is the button for the reverse rotation. These buttons have the operations. They can be pressed or unpressed. These diodes are used here, and they are connected in reverse bias. Then this forward is connected here. So though no direct line is shown between this point and this, but you can understand that this particular point is connected here to the port 0 line 0, and to the port 0 line 1 this reverse point is connected. Then so port 0, it acts as the input port, whereas port 2 acts as the output port, and only 4 lines of that port are used, and they are given to this particular driver, which is LN2003A, and the outputs of this particular driver, they are connected to the stepper motor. So outputs are A, B, C and D, and they are connected to the inputs A, B, C and D. So this particular stepper motor, which operates on plus 12 volt DC, will rotate either in the forward direction or it will rotate in the reverse direction, and that depends on what sequence of bits are coming on this A, B, C and D, and it is decided through the program which is given to this particular microcontroller. So as we have seen, you can see here, this is the program which is there with the microcontroller 8051. The same program is available in the PPT. And when we go for simulation of this, then in the simulation that particular program will be executed, and as the program is executed, the motor will rotate either in the forward direction or reverse direction depending on whether the forward key is pressed or reverse key is pressed. So let us start the simulation. So here you have got a play button to start the simulation. So here I have started the simulation. Right now you can see that the motor is not rotating either in the forward direction or reverse direction, even if simulation is started. As I press the forward button, then it started in the forward direction. Now as I press the reverse button, it is rotating in the reverse direction. Okay, so you can rotate the motor either in the forward direction or you can rotate the motor in the reverse direction by pressing these particular keys. So this is the operation of this particular stepper motor, and it is the simulation that we have seen. So going back to the program, you can see here that I will not explain all the code. You can thoroughly go through that particular code. The main points I will tell in this particular code. First of all, here in this particular code, a decision is taken by using these two instructions in B, and these two in B instructions, which are reading port 0, 0th line, and port 0, 1st line, to sense whether the motor is to be rotated in the clockwise direction, that is the forward direction, or the reverse direction. If it is to be rotated in the forward direction, then this particular line will be 0, and it takes a jump here. And if it is to be rotated in the reverse direction, then this will be 0 and it takes a jump here. Whereas if both are 1, then it will not take either this jump or this jump, but it will come to these instructions. It will send 00 on the port 2 and the short jump wait. So it will go here. That means it will be in this particular infinite loop, and it will neither rotate the motor in the forward direction or in the reverse direction. Now, if it is to be rotated in the forward direction, then it starts here. It is going to read from that particular table the data which is to be sent to the port 2. Okay. So it is going to read one of the number from this particular table. So this is the table, and in which there are 8 entries. Okay, initial entry is 00, but after that there are 8 entries. So to this particular table 1, a number is added. So if 1 is added, you get 2. If 2 is added, you get 6. If 3 is added, you get 4. If 8 is added, you get this last number 3. So what is added in the beginning, you can see here is that the DPTR first, it points to the beginning of the table. Okay, DPTR, and in R4 register, 1 is taken for the forward direction, and from R4 it is taken into accumulator A register, and move C is the instruction, that is move from the program memory, and which memory, the address of that memory is specified by DPTR plus contents of A register. So DPTR is pointing at that particular table, at the beginning of the table 1, and A is added to it. So what is there in A? Right now it is 1. So the first number in that particular table will be read, or the first sequence will be read, and that sequence is sent on to the port 2, and after calling a delay, a short jump is called is caused to key. Whereas if the motor is to be rotated in the reverse direction, then in that case the jump is caused to this NEG, and here the contents of R4 are 7, and the contents of R4 are moved or transferred to A, and here move C A plus DPTR. So DPTR contains the table, it is at the base of the table 1, and the number 7 is added to that. So the last number in that table is read, and the contents of that particular location, which is the last sequence, is there, will be taken into accumulator, and from accumulator it is sent to port 2, and eventually it goes to the stepper motor. Okay, so the last sequence is sent to the stepper motor if it is to be rotated in the reverse direction. Okay, then after this, the jump is caused to the key. So here is the key. Now here, depending on whether that particular pin P0.0 is 0 or the other pin is 0, so the contents of R4 are further incremented or they are decremented. So based on that, it is either incremented or it is decremented. And how long it is incremented? It is incremented, then it is compared with 9. Okay, so every time, now this is the loop, and this particular loop is executed. This particular loop is executed as long as the key is pressed. So if this particular pin is 1, then it is incremented. Jump if beat P0.0, then it jumps to NR1. So if that is 1, then it jumps here. Whereas if this particular pin is low, then it increments R4. If the value of R4 has reached, that is, this instruction is compare and jump if not equal to compare and jump if not equal to 9. So if it has reached 9, then it is reduced to 1. Otherwise, it is incremented. Its initial value is 1 for forward direction. So from 1 it goes to 2, from 2 to 2 to 3, 4, 5, 6. So like that, it keeps on incrementing up to 9. If it becomes 9, then it is taken to 1. And the jump is caused here. Then the contents of R4 are transferred to A, and from that table you read it. So next sequence is taken and it is sent to the port 2. A delay is caused, and again here the short jump is to key. So every time, or this is the loop you can see, and when this loop is executed, if the rotation is in forward direction, every time in this loop what happens is that the contents of R4 are incremented by 1. Whereas if the rotation is in the reverse direction, then this condition holds true. It jumps here, and here it checks whether that particular pin is 0. If it is 0, then it will not jump to start. If it is if this is 1, then it will go to start. But if it is 0, then it means that the rotation is to be in the reverse direction. So it will decrement R4. So initially, if you remember, that R4 was set to 7, so it is decremented by 1, and it is checked whether the R4 has reached 0. If R4 has reached 0, then R4 will be set to 8. Then it comes down here. So from the contents of R4 are transferred to A, and this move C instruction will read from the table using DPTR. So here it reads from the DPTR, contents of A decides which particular number is to be read from the table. So DPTR is pointing at the beginning of the table, and that particular sequence is read. You can note here that the contents of R4, they are decreasing every time by 1. So from the table, the sequence will be read, but it will be read in the reverse direction, and every time it is sent to the port 2, and after delay the next iteration will start. And as long as this particular pin P0.1 is low, it will keep on executing this particular instructions. Okay, that is, the motor will rotate in the reverse direction. And this is the subroutine for delay. So this particular routine will provide the required delay. So this was the demonstration for the interfacing of the stepper motor with 8051. If you have not understood anything from this, then you can ask that specific theory, that particular specific point, I shall be happy to provide the explanation for what you have not understood. So thank you for your patient listening, and we shall meet for next such demonstration. Thank you.